Hi everybody, and welcome along to this little flip through of the latest journal that I've created, which is a design team project for Liana Scrap. She has a shop on Etsy with loads of lovely printables. This one is called Vintage Poppies, and I appreciate the fact that we are, you know, still in the early spring and you associate poppies with summertime. But I just felt like I just had to do it. I just love it. So the outside, it's design paper, some nice cotton fabric down there. And I've just put that on the spine because the whole journal is cream and this sort of orangey red. And the back as well has got design paper on it. And all the corners have got book corners on them. So they look quite nice and smart. Inside we have, well, you can see we have two signatures. And I've left loads of room for journaling in this because I was thinking to myself, I was making a journal for me to use. I would want something where there actually is plenty of space to write. And I'm as guilty as anyone of making journals that look really pretty but actually aren't that practical. So with this one, I wanted to leave a lot of journaling room. In fact, so much so that I might go back and make another version of it for me, just to keep a journal. I think I'd really like to do that. So even on the front cover, we've got journaling space there. Even if you just wanted to say the date you started the journal, perhaps something like that. Then here we've got one of the lovely design sheets. This colour, this sort of apple green colour, is throughout the kit. And maybe that's what drew me to it. I don't know. I really love that colour. Sort of chartreuse, light olive. I don't know how to describe it, but it's really pretty. So this is a design sheet. And this is a design sheet as well. But it's got lines to journal on. It's lovely. Then here we have a piece of coffee stained paper. And on here, I've made one of those pockets. I've shown you how to make them before. I've stuck it right down, so there's nothing behind there. But there is a pocket there, and I haven't sewn this or stuck this. So there is room to get your journaling cards in with no problem at all. They're all backed and ready for journaling. So even on this page where there's no official journaling, if you like, you can still journal on the back of the cards. And I love this image. I mean, it's perfect. And then on the back of here, I've just done a little collage with some of the remnants I had left over from the design sheets. Just put that there, and a little butterfly that isn't in the kit, but we all have butterflies, don't we? And here, plenty of journaling room. Throughout the book, the journal, I've put these little red folders, file folder things in. A card with a tab on is what it is. And I really don't know why. I wanted to bring the red back into it somehow. And I quite like the idea that it's split up. So, you know, you can turn to various parts in your journal. So there we have that. These are all from the design papers. This is a design page, but you could easily journal on that, on all of it. This is just plain tea stained paper with a little stencil on, flower stencil that I have. And then on the back here, we've got a corner pocket like that, and one of my patchwork tabs. I think I did a video showing you how to do these. They are addictive. Once you start, you cannot stop. And I've just backed it and put some of the stencil. I've used candied apple for the colour for the ink, but I haven't gone overboard with it. For example, you know, I haven't inked around a page, or I haven't inked around there, because I did try it, but it all started to look a bit much. So none of these are inked around. Another design sheet with a beautiful lady. And on the back of that, I've printed the lined paper that also comes in the kit. And then on here, we've got one of these sort of foldy things that I first showed you in the Mr. Green journal that we did. I might have shown you it before, actually. And it's just a little tag in there that you could journal in, and there's a little journaling card in there. So they pop into there. That pops into there. Come on, you know you want to go in. That's it. And then behind that, because I've only stuck it down on three sides, we've got another patchwork tag. Can't get my tags and my tabs sorted out today. And I've just backed it and stenciled it, so that fits in there. Then on the back of that, just a plain page for journaling with some of those stencils that I do. This is a design page, and look at it's perfect. It's got all the poppies on, it's really pretty, and yet it's still got this sort of cartouche really for journaling on. This is the center of signature one. Really nice, beautiful design paper. If you're into poppies like I am, it's just gorgeous. And there we have another one with this sort of cartouche in the center. Here we've got another just decoration on the side of the page. I don't know what more I can say, really. It just takes a blankness off it. And there are more journaling and more journaling. So there is, as I say, quite a lot of room for straight up journaling here. That's a design page and it's beautiful. Here we've got a little tummy tuck, and I've made two envelopes and just tied them together with a piece of twine, and they fit inside the band. Just get the little lugs out of the bow, like so. And that looks pretty, I think. I like that. I made those on the envelope punch board because they're really quite small. I didn't have anything that size. Then on the back, just another little bit of page decoration. That is so pretty, that paper, and a butterfly. I'm pretty sure those butterflies were a freebie from Artie Mays, so thank you very much, Andrea. I use them a lot. Look at that. That might be my favourite, actually. I say that all the time, but it's gorgeous, isn't it? It's really lovely. Journaling page on the back of there, but not plain. It's still got this bit of pattern on it. Really nice. And here's another divider here with another lovely lady on it. And on the back of that, another lovely lady. And then here we've got a patchwork tag with a patchwork pocket. They're really nice to make these. If you want to have a go, look up the video. It's straightforward, really is, very straightforward. And you'll enjoy doing them, I'm sure you will, if you're a sewer. Then here we've got a decoupage napkin. I had to include it. I absolutely had to include it. It's lovely. And it does fill up pretty much all of that page. There is a little bit up there, but... and then here we've got journaling. Nice lined paper with, oh, such pretty poppies. And that's the end of the first signature. Second signature starts with a gorgeous piece of design paper. There really are some nice papers in here. I'm not making it up. There are some lovely papers. Plenty journaling, but it's got this distressed sort of border around it. That appeals to me enormously. Here we have a corner pocket with a journaling card that I've backed with the lined paper and poppies. So that just fits into there. I haven't stuck this edge down here, so it goes in there quite easily. And just a little collage down the side. This one's got this lovely lady on it and a nice image from the design papers. And this, the lined paper with the poppies. It's so nice. This is another one of those ones that's sort of kind of distressed around the edge. It's really nice, but you can journal over the whole thing. And here we have just, it's a tea stain page with some stencils on, and I've just added this little floating pocket to it, really. That's all that is. And it's just a journal card with a tab on it so you can see that it's actually in there. Otherwise you might lose it. So that goes in there and it just fits on with a paper clip like that. And then on the back, we've just got a nice collage there with a butterfly just down in this corner. So you've got lots of room there. I love that image. It is the image that's on the front, but I had to include it again because it's so pretty. So pretty. And on the back, lined paper for journaling. And here we've got another patchwork pocket and patchwork tag. Just wait till you start doing this and you'll see why I really like them. That hasn't been backed, but it will be backed. That's got past me, I'm afraid, that one. But I will back it with cream card. Just a journaling page with a little bit of stenciling on. And look at this page. This is gorgeous. I love it. These two pictures, really. And then this sort of, it's blue and white. It's a picture of poppies, but just a sketch. Gorgeous. Center of this signature, which is all journaling. Lots of space there. Then that lovely image, tummy tuck here, and I've stenciled the paper behind, and just one of those lovely images that I've put onto red card, and you can easily journal on that. So that just fits in there. A little collage down the side, a couple of butterflies, some journaling space. Oh, I love this one too. I love the way that's all distressed. It's the only word I can think of. Then here we have a journaling page that I've just put stencils on, and clipped on the side is a little one of these foldy outy envelope things that we made. It's all decoupage, which I quite like because it's all poppies and cornflowers, which is lovely. It just sits on the edge there and it's clipped in with one of these very nice paper clips like that. So that's what you see on the other side. Journaling, beautiful lady, another beautiful lady. And doesn't she stand out so well on this red card? It's really nice. And that picture, oh, what a treat, it's beautiful. And then on this side, we've got just a decoupage bit with a butterfly on. That's a very nice spread, I really like that one. Here we have a patchwork pocket, but I haven't put a patchwork tag in. I've put a design paper tag in, backed with a cream card. So that fits in there. And then some journaling here. And that design page on the back. And here, you know, you could write, you know, supposing you'd taken it away for a holiday, you could write, you know, Scotland 2021, if we're lucky enough to have a holiday, or wherever you are, you know, whatever you've been doing and the date that you ended the journal. So there we have it. I haven't put a tie on it. I don't think it needs it. Haven't filled it too full of stuff. So it's ready to go. And I really like it. I think it's useful. And it's a lovely size. let me just tell you what size this is, actually. It is 7.25 by 5. So it's smaller than the normal ones that I do. And you can see, compared to my hand, it's quite little. And it does fit in your hand very nicely. It's really making me want to journal. So who knows, I might progress from here. So thanks very much for watching. You'll find this for sale on my Etsy shop, which is Miss Paint-A-Lot. And if you want it, I hope you get it. Bye.